Let's learn how to get around an object before hitting it.
3, 2, 1, Lego!
The final sensor our robot is equipped with is an infrared or IR sensor. Use a similar system when turning on and off your TV. The front of the remote has an IR transmitter, and your TV has a receiver. Garages have a brake beam system that looks like this. One end is a transmitter and one end is a receiver. Our sensor has both a transmitter and a receiver in this case, which is why it looks like eyes. One side emits light and the other side looks to see how much light is reflected. An emitter might be similar to an IR LED, or a collector would be like this photo cell. The sensor can tell the robot's proximity to an object. Closer an object is, the more light is reflected into the sensor. The sensor gives you a relative distance. 100% means the object is really far away, and 0% means, well, you've probably hit the wall. Reflectivity also depends on the type of material. We measured the reflectivity of our black wall compared to a hardcover notebook, a cardboard notepad, and we've gotten varying results. The correlation between the percent and the distance isn't even linear. And if you angle the surface, the values also change. Even with all this, we still have a good enough estimate to create a program for our robot. We want it to make a decision, so we're going to use a switch. We want the robot to compare its proximity to an object. When the robot reads a value of over 50%, it's probably more than 6 inches from the wall. Remember to put everything inside of an infinite loop. And when it reads a value greater than 50%, we want it to move forward. And if the value is less than 50%, we want it to turn before it hits the wall. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. You can also chat with us on Twitter, Tumblr, Reddit, Instagram, and Facebook. And remember, keep exploring.